on the other side of things, you did bring up the Young Bucks. And it was very interesting thing that dropped at 3 a.m. was about the Young Bucks airing the footage from the Jack Perry and CM Punk incident on live on Dynamite this Wednesday, to which there were immediate reactions to it. I saw a few sites and a couple of accounts that are saying, no, they're airing other footage, nothing to do with CM Punk. And then later on, even today, that was refuted by Brian Alvarez, who said, no, they are absolutely showing the CM Punk footage. So I think people have their wires crossed as to what they're actually going to show, which honestly, I wouldn't be surprised if AEW is leaking some bad information just to create chaos.
Well, who could they leak it to? Their friends? Their personal friends that run... I mean, God, it sounds so funny when we say it like this because it makes it way more serious than it is. It's like, your friends run the media. And it's like, it's not real media, guys. It's right. It's just you have fucking dorks with websites. No, I'm pretty confident of the fact that this is a big ruse. I think this is I feel like this is going to end up being a comedy skit by the Elite because they're so funny.
I hope so, because if they do it the other way, I mean, I think with the comedy skit, they can get out of this with a less of a black eye. I know. I think you feel a little bit differently, but I think if it's a comedy skit, they can get out with, oh, look, it's corny Young Buck shit again. But if they try to play this legit, could you imagine them trying to play? See, this is what this man has done to our company. Like, dude, every single person that believes in that company will stop believing after that.
Yeah, I mean, this. I don't know how to. I guess you're right in the sense maybe that's the glass half full version.
Yeah,
I just see it as lose, 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 lose all over the place. If anything, I see this little like hissy fit by them. Do you remember the Island Boys?
Yeah. Island Boys.
Island Boys. And then they just like the clout faded out. So they just started making out with each other on Instagram to get people to pay attention to them. Yeah. That's what this feels like to me. Where I'm just like the Jacksons are just bordering on like maybe we need to make out so people will pay attention to us. It's one of those things where maybe you have the best idea there, or it's like, is it a bait and switch? And look, they're heels and they really healed on us. And I'm like, the Young Bucks truly don't understand anything about psychology, people, wrestling, any of it. Like, it's like, guys, that's not good heat.
No,
at all. That's not good heat. Like the idea of saying we're going to do this thing, and then you try to do like a DX style skit or whatever. You know,
how about the fact that they still need CM Punk to pop a rating?
I know
the guy is gone from the company, and they still need him to get people to watch their program.
Yeah, all they had to do was not be fucking awful to him, and they could have, you know, actually had him there helping. Isn't that weird?
That's
all they had to do was not completely fuck the relationship up and dissolve it via their immaturity and want to run a fucking playground. Like, that's all it had to be.
Yeah.
I don't know where they go with this. If they do, suppose all of this is real and they show the video, right? Unless CM Punk is literally blasting women in the face and screaming racial slurs, what's going to be in this that would be so shocking? You know what I mean?
Right. Yeah. I mean, that's the whole thing is, are they trying to insinuate that everything CM Punk said on Ariel Helwani was a lie? Are they trying to insinuate that, you know, Jumpin' Jungle Jack Perry boy is right, and you know everything is CM, like, what are they gonna do, show that chunk CM Punk didn't choke him a little, CM Punk choked him a lot? Like,
yeah, I'd like if it was chunk from the fucking Goonies just showed up there. He'd be the most charismatic person on that roster right now for the most part, aside from like Samoa Joe. I don't, what could possibly happen other than like there's Jack Perry, I don't know, holding a baby, you know, I don't know, maybe petting a puppy, And then CM Punk runs up and just starts clobbering him in the face.
Yeah.
Maybe what could you do to make this seem like he really was a motherfucker here? You know, and by the way, if he really was a motherfucker here, why did it take this long for anybody to say anything?
I think there was an NDA in place for a lot of this shit, though. That's the weird thing. So
I guess
they're just going to blow through an NDA, too. Now, what does that mean? If there's like an NDA on this stuff and they blow through it, that NDA works both ways. This is when we call up Jeff and go, Jeff, what does this fucking mean? But it can't be good. You're not allowed to just blow through an NDA without repercussions. So I imagine CM Punk might even be happy that they're doing this.
Yeah, if this turns out to not just be a sketch, which still, like I said, that's not going to go over well either.
Right.
That's also not going to work out well for you. It also just goes completely against everything they did 5 days prior.
Oh yeah.
Edge coming out and going like, I love pro wrestling. It's the best thing in the world. We should all be friends. I want to cuddle with wrestling. I just want to give it smooches on its lips. I love it. We should just make a cocoon of wrestling and we all just live in it and smush around and roll around and kiss. We should all kiss.
Yeah.
You know, like, how does it go from that to 5 days later? Expose on CM Punk.
I know.
After 2 years of us just sitting there, like, you know, with our little thumbs in our mouths, being like, "Hee, we'll never tell."
It's dumb. What? It's dumb, and it's gonna come back to haunt them. I don't see anything good coming from this. Like I said, you're right. My glass half full is that they don't actually try to pretend that CM Punk is this evil monger that the company is finally free from, as opposed to them doing a stupid bit. Because at least the stupid bit is, even though you're right, the stupid bit will still be embarrassing and shitty. And at the end of the day is more promotion for WWE, I guess. But at least they can, you know, people can just groan at it like a bad joke and maybe move on. Like maybe that's the last hurrah of it. But I don't know, man. If this is like the way that Brian Alvarez is saying that this is a legit thing and they're showing the footage, I don't know what kind of goodwill they're going to get from this. It's just going to make everybody look bad.
No,
and look, let's be honest. The people that have already made up their minds about CM Punk don't need any more convincing either way. If you're in favor of what CM Punk has said, and if you believe him and stuff like that, you're pretty much all set. There's nothing the Young Bucks or Tony Khan or AEW that is going to say that's going to change your mind. And same goes for the people that are in the AEW camp. If you hate CM Punk and think that CM Punk is the devil, why keep kicking a dead horse? He's gone. He's no longer in your fucking company. Be happy he's gone. You know?
Right, right. Well, this is where it goes back to the whole, you know, what I'm sure Edge was trying to break up with, which is the tribalism and the belief of the tribalism. And it's like, well, it's not really a tribe when one group of people is, I don't know, 4 or 5 million people,
right,
let's say. Maybe 3 million people are big WWE fans that regularly watch the show, and then probably even 70% of those people aren't actively on the internet. They just like it,
right?
And the other fan base is like 400,000 people at best. You know what I mean? Like, it's, that's not exactly a tribal warfare that would go well. But the idea of saying like, yeah, look at what an asshole you are, it's still going back to, you know, to make it political. Nobody, if you're running around with your fucking MAGA hat and, you know, like Donald Trump is the greatest guy in the world, there's no expose of him that's going to sway you.
Right.
Do you know what I mean? Like, I don't know, shy of a video of, you know, a video of him on Epstein's Island slammed. What the fuck? Nobody's, they've made their minds.
Right.
Their minds are firmly made up.
Right.
They're firmly in place.
This is going to do absolutely nothing for anybody, but maybe ease or soothe the ego of the Young Bucks, soothe the ego of Jack Perry, soothe the ego of Tony Khan. Because let's also be honest, Joe, even if that is a video that they take from the incident, how much do you want to bet that it's going to be heavily edited? Heavily edited. It's going to be like 100 jump cuts in 60 seconds. You know what
it's
I mean?
Like Davy and Goliath. It's going to be like, is this stop motion? What is going on here? I don't know what they're attempting to accomplish here. Right. I really don't get it other than, look at me, please give me attention. Look, please, we matter. I swear we're still something over here. I swear. And I saw the Meltzer response because, you know, he has to defend them because they're his friends.
Of course.
They're his very good personal friends, whether he wants to say it or not.
His ring boys.
He's like, well, do you remember when Bret Hart promised Shawn Michaels was gonna pay her and they sent out a dwarf? Was it bad when they did that or something? And we're like, Dave, that was a quarter of a century ago.
Right.
25 years ago, a thing happened on Monday Night Raw. Aren't we supposed to learn from these things? Aren't we supposed to know that wasn't good?
Right, right.
Do you remember when the Wayne brothers released 15 movies where a joke every minute in that would have people's jaws on the floor today? And it's like, that was completely acceptable? Where they were just like, why don't we just make a series of movies where the entire theme is being offensive? And people are like, yeah, sounds great. We'll just do that. Yeah, that was in 1997 too, Dave. That doesn't mean you go, oh, somebody's going to make that. And it's going to be good. It's going to be good and people are going to like it. And they're going to think that's great.
They're underneath this moral really high ground. That's the thing too, is you can't just sit there and say that this is about the incident. I think if there's people out there that believe that this is just about airing the truth, I think you're short-sighted. Please. Because I think this is more about them establishing their moral high ground in this scenario. That's what's being done. I don't look at this bit or this footage reveal as anything else other than soothing the hurt ego and making themselves seem like, hey, look, we were right to get rid of CM Punk. Our company is now better because of it. Here's the proof. And it's just, like I said, it even goes back to what I was saying just a second ago. It's all about, you're not going to convince anybody of something that they don't already believe. If people already believe that CM Punk is the devil, then this isn't going to further prove it to them. It's like, what are you doing? You're just preaching to your own choir. And then for the people that like CM Punk and think that the Young Bucks and AEW is a bunch of horse shit, they're not going to be like, oh, well, you proved it to me. I guess the rest of the 2-hour show is going to be fantastic now that you proved that CM Punk is a piece of shit.
Oh, well, then I better stay tuned for what's his name? Lance Archer versus like the show sucks.
Right.
It's a bad show.
It's not going to do anything other than cause drama. And that's what AEW is about now. They're about causing drama inside the ring, outside the ring, whether it's unhappy wrestlers or unhappy fans or whatever it might be, or crazy amounts of money being thrown at people that don't deserve a quarter of it. That's what they are now. They're a freak show. AEW is wrestling's freak show.
Yeah. Yeah. And yes, they got dunked on all weekend. But at some point you have to go, guys, it's time for you to take your lumps. It's right. Time for you to take your lumps. You spent 5 years shitting on WWE. You spent 5 years trying to get your jabs in. That's quite long enough for now these guys to start making little jokes about them, for Pat McAfee to make little goofy digs, or for Triple H to say something about the sweet, precious angel Will Ospreay. and how dare he say something about Will Ospreay?
Right.
You know what I mean? Well, we wouldn't really want him here. Folks, I got good news for you. All right? For anybody that's a big, big Will Ospreay fan, I think Will Ospreay's really good too. But he's a hoe.
Right? Yeah, he's a one-day hoe.
He's a hoe. I mean, he's really fucking, he's a talented, athletic, engaging, entertaining young man. And he's a hoe.
But he will slurp that box for a dollar.
He's a dirty little hoe. I mean, that's fine. It's fine. I'm not slut-shaming him. I think it's... I'm not holding that against him. He's not a sugar daddy.
Yeah,
daddy wants him to show up and cut promos and drop on his head. That's what daddy wants. And that's what he chose to do.
Right.
And that's fine. But don't make me pretend that he's not a hoe.
Right. Right.
That's fine. It's fucking fine. Once again, live your life.
You want to go to the strip club? That's fine. Enjoy the strip club, guys. You want to come home and have a home cooked meal by somebody who loves you? Then, you know, watch WWE.
Yeah, you can't. And you know, I mean, what is it they say? You can't turn a hoe into a housewife. Is that what the saying is? Well, you can't turn a hoe into an active wrestler.
You want a wrestler to give you a lap dance for $10? Hey, that's fine. You want WWE to rub your feet after a hard day? That's good too.
Yeah, you know? So these are all choices. Yeah. These are all choices that are okay. And to the people that I saw that were like, well, I mean, shouldn't that be the goal? To make as much money as you can and not hurt yourself? And I'm like, yes, absolutely. For the stripper. Yeah, but that's the same thing as being, same thing.
For the stripper it is, but what about the fans?
Right.
Fuck. I love all these people just sucking these poor wrestlers have to work one day a week for $1 million. Oh, it's so horrible.
Oh no.
And I'm like, well,
what if they go to WWE and have to wrestle 3 days a week for $700,000?
I mean, at some point you have to flip that script. It can't always be about, look at the company, look at how much better these people are treated because they're getting more money. Because at the end of the day, if they're not doing anything, why the fuck do you care? Right. If you're not watching them on TV, if they're not working for their fucking money to make them value.